तो गाइस, हमने केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम में अब तक जो भी लेक्चर्स पढ़े हैं वो बेसिक इंट्रोडक्टिव पार्ट था, करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम, हाउ टू राइट इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट ऑफ अ रिएक्शन, हाउ टू राइट केपी एंड केसी, एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड टू रिलेशंस बिटवीन टू डिफरेंट इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट्स. दीज रिलेशंस वाई नंबर फर्स्ट आई विल रिकैप देम. केपी इज इक्वल टू केसी इनटू आरटी रेज टू पावर डेल एन, एंड नंबर सेकंड रिलेशन वाज between two equilibrium constants, k is equal to 1 by k dash. Under what conditions we have discussed. Now number third relationship is, if a reversible chemical reaction is written in multiple steps. Having equilibrium constants, k equilibrium constants k1, k2, k3 dash up to kn, then the total equilibrium constant of the overall reaction, that will be equal to k1 into k2 into k3. Now let us see what does this statement mean. If I consider a reaction and that reaction can be written in number of steps, then we can determine equilibrium constant of the overall reaction. For example, let us consider a reaction like this. N2 plus O2 gives twice NO. This is N2 plus O2 gives twice NO2. Now 2 times nitrogen, 2 times nitrogen, and 4 times oxygen, 4 times oxygen. This is a reversible reaction. For this reaction, equilibrium constant is K. Now I can write equilibrium constant of this reaction K is equal to concentration of products. That's active mass of products divided by active mass of reactants. What are products? It's NO2. Active mass, it is taken in square brackets, or this is active mass raised to power its stoichiometry, that is 2, divided by active mass of reactant, that's N2, and active mass of another reactant, that's O2, raised to power its stoichiometry, that is 2. Here the stoichiometry is 1, that's why I have not mentioned it. If I write this equation in multiple steps, in more than one way, if I prepare this NO2 in more than one way. For example, if I suppose the reaction takes place like this in first setup, N2 plus O2 combined together to give NO. Now in the second setup, NO combines with the oxygen to give NO2. Now this is twice. This is twice. Now we have two different equations, two different equilibria. Considering the mechanism of this reaction, for this reaction equilibrium constant, let it is k1, and for this reaction equilibrium constant is k2. Then since if a reaction whose equilibrium constant is k can be written in multiple steps with equilibrium k1 and k2, then the overall equilibrium constant of this reaction, overall equilibrium constant, this k, it will be equal to k1 into k2. Now let us prove it. It will be equal to k1 into k2. Now determine k1 from here. K1 will be equal to concentration of product, that's NO whole square, divided by concentration of reactant, that's N2, to concentration of reactant, that's oxygen. Now assume that these are gaseous species. Similarly, we can determine K2 over here. K2 will be equal to N2 NO2 raised to power 2 divided by NO raised to power 2 into oxygen raised to power 1. Now, overall rate constant, this K is equal to K1 into K2. Let us prove it. K is equal to K1 into K2. Now, K is this. We have to prove this thing will be equal to this thing into this thing. What is K1? K is equal to, what's K1? K1 is NO raised to power 2 divided by N2 raised to power O2. What is K2? K2 is NO2. NO2 raised to power 2 divided by NO raised to power 2 into O2 raised to power 1. Now see, NO2 and NO2 will get cancelled out. What remains over here? K will be equal to concentration of NO2 whole square divided by concentration of nitrogen and concentration of oxygen. Oxygen raised to power 1 raised to power 1, powers are added, that's oxygen raised to power 2. Now see, this is equal to our K, NO2 whole square, NO2 whole square divided by N2 divided by N2 and oxygen raised to power 2. This is equal to K. Hence we prove that if a reaction, we can write in multiple ways. There are number of ways by which we can represent the process. Then K equilibrium is equal to K1 into K2. This is number third relation. We have got it. A question can be framed for this equation. If you are given K1 and K2, you can determine K. For the following reaction, the same reaction, for the following reaction, N2 plus O2 gives NO2. N2 plus O2 gives NO2. Now this is a reaction for we people. For this equilibrium constant, determine equilibrium constant for this reaction. Determine equilibrium constant for this reaction. If K1 and K2 for the reaction shown below are given. K1 and K2 are given. Now K1 first, that is one way of dealing with this reaction is N2 plus O2 gives NO. Now for this K1 is equal to 3 into 10 raised to power minus 15. Similarly, we can have second reaction, that is NO plus oxygen gives NO2. For this K2 will be equal to, K2 is given, it is 4 into 10 raised to power minus 15. Now determine K, since this reaction is written as K1 and K2, by multiplying K1 and K2, determining K1 over here, determining K2 over here, and multiplying K1 and K2, you are getting this type of equation, equilibrium constant K of this reaction. Then K will be equal to equilibrium constant K1 into K2. What is K1? That is 3 into 10 raised power minus 15 into 4 into 10 raised power minus 15. Now you can solve it, you can get the answer 3 fourths are 10 into 10 raised power minus 15. This is the equilibrium constant of this reaction. This is how you have to solve, you have to approach questions. Now, up to now we have discussed certain relations. They were very important. One relation was K is equal to K1 into K2, Kp is equal to Kc Rt raised to power delta n, g number of moles of gas products minus reactants. Kf1 reaction is equal to 1 by K dash of backward reaction if the reaction proceeds in other way. These were certain relations. And one more relation, K equilibrium is equal to K forward by K backward. This was one more relation. You can solve a question if your K equilibrium for this reaction is given, for example, 49. K dash is given 49. You can determine K. Then it will be 1 divided by 49. Like this, you have to solve the questions. Now, coming to the units of equilibrium constant. This is very important. Units of equilibrium constant. Now, question may be asked and are asked from here. Now, units of equilibrium constant, we have two types of equilibrium constant, Kc and Kp. Kc is when we express concentration in terms of molarity, and this is when we express concentration in terms of partial pressure. Now, unit of Kc is equal to molarity, because concentration is molarity, raised to power del m, g. And unit of Kp is equal to unit of pressure is either atmosphere or bar raised to the power del mg. For example, if we have a reaction H2 plus I2 gives to HI, you have to determine the units of this reaction. Determine unit of this reaction. Now, what are the units of this reaction? You have to determine del mg over here. Del mg is equal to number of moles of gaseous reactants minus number of moles of gaseous products. Total number of moles of gaseous products, number of moles of gaseous products minus number of moles of gaseous reactants. Total number of moles of gaseous products over here is 2, and number of moles of gaseous reactants is 1 and 1, that is 2. Del mg is equal to 0. Therefore, unit of Kc in terms of concentration, or Kp in terms of pressure, it will be equal to molarity. Molarity is concentration. It's a concentration term. Molarity is equal to mole per liter. Mole per liter. Therefore, we can write it mole liter minus 1 raised to the power del mg. Therefore, it becomes molarity, that's concentration, that is mole liter minus 1 raised to the power 0. Anything raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, for this reaction, unit of Kc is not definite. It is not definite. It's a unitless quantity for this reaction. Means if the number of moles of products is equal to the number of moles of reactants, then the units of Kc and Kp, they are not definite. Similarly, unit of Kp is expressed in terms of atmosphere. That's equal to atmosphere raised to the power del mg. What is del mg over here? It is 0. That's atmosphere raised to the power 0, that's 1. Therefore, it's a unitless quantity for this reaction. Therefore, we can't say equilibrium constant has this unit or that unit unless we are given the reaction, unless we determine del mg, number of moles of gaseous products and number of moles of gaseous reactants. Now, let us solve 2-3 questions over here. From equilibrium constant, from equilibrium, if we write equilibrium of a reaction, we can write the balanced chemical equation from equilibrium reaction. Now let us consider a question. Kc for a reaction, given question, Kc is equal to equilibrium constant is equal to I2 into H2IO65 divided by IO3 minus IO3 raised to the power 7, H2O raised to the power 9, H positive raised to the power 7. Now you are given 4 options. You have to tell which is the balanced chemical equation of this. Now in order to determine balanced chemical equation, we have nothing to do. We have to multiply this thing with this. Means this term, we have to bring out it over here. Now bring this term over here. This becomes equal to IO3 raised to the power 7. IO3 raised to the power 7 means it is 7 times IO3. 7 times IO3. Now similarly, plus water, how many times? It is 9 times. Similarly, H positive, how many times? It is 7 times. It gives these are products, these are our reactants, because reactants we write in the denominator and products in the numerator. Now this is I2 plus H2, I2, O6 is 5 times. If you write Kc for this reaction, it will be this, right? Kc. Kc will be equal to concentration of products, that's I2, into concentration of another product, that is this H2, I2, O6 raised to power 5, divided by concentration of these reactants. What is reactant? It's IO3 raised to power 7 into concentration of water. What is concentration of water? Raised to power 9 into concentration of H positive raised to power its stoichiometry, that is 7. Therefore, from Kc or Kp, from the given Kc or Kp expression, you can determine the nature of the reaction. You can determine the balanced chemical equation. This is one more method how you can determine the balanced chemical equation. Now let us do one more type of question that are frequently asked on this basis. Now let us consider a question. In an experiment, an experiment is carried out. 1 mole of acetic acid and 1 mole of alcohol. 1 mole of acetic acid means acetic acid, we have 1 mole, and 1 mole of alcohol, we have ethanol, CH3CH2OH, 1 mole of ethanol, are allowed to react until equilibrium is established. Means we have a reaction vessel. In this reaction vessel, we are mixing acetic acid, CH3COH, 1 mole of this, and 1 mole of ethanol, C2H5OH, it's 1 mole. They are allowed to react until equilibrium is established. Let equilibrium is established. After equilibrium, that equilibrium is equilibrium mixture contains. Equilibrium mixture was found to contain 2/3 moles of acetic acid. Equilibrium mixture was found to contain 2/3 moles of acetic acid. Means these two react, they form ester. They form ester. Now what is ester over here? Ester is CH3C double bond O. Single bond O, single bond C2H5. This is ester plus we get water over here. Now see, 1 mole of this combines with 1 mole of this to form at equilibrium 2/3 moles of this. Now we have to determine, determine equilibrium constant of the reaction. We have to determine Kc. You can write this question, right? I will write down in an experiment. In an experiment, 1 mole of acetic acid, in an experiment, 1 mole of acetic acid and 1 mole of alcohol were allowed to react until equilibrium was attained. The equilibrium mixture was found to contain 2.3 moles of ester. Determine the equilibrium constant of a reaction. Now, this is question we have to solve it. Now, see, let us try to solve this question. We have to determine Kc, equilibrium constant. The given is, we have 1 mole of this, 1 mole of this. Now see, when the reaction starts, we have 1 mole of this and 1 mole of this. Since the reaction has started, we have nothing of this and water. We have water over here as well as a byproduct over here is water. We have 0 moles of this. Now at equilibrium stage, 2/3 moles of this are formed. 2/3 moles of this, 2/3 moles of this will be formed. Means 2/3 moles of acetic acid have been lost over here, have been decomposed over here to form this. Therefore, how many remains over here? 1 minus 2/3, 1 minus 2/3. This is 1 minus 2/3, 1 minus 2/3, and it's 2/3 moles are formed. It is 2/3 moles are formed. Now, solve this. 3 ones are 3 minus 2, that is 3 minus 2, 1/4. This is 1/4. This is 2/3 and this is 2/3. These are the number of moles. We express equilibrium constant for this reaction in this form. Product of concentration of product is, this is ester. Now I will write ester. This is ester and this is water. Raise it to power their stoichiometry, that's 1 and 1. Divided by, this is acid and this is alcohol. I will write divided by acid into alcohol for simplicity. Alcohol. Now this is concentration. When we write in square brackets, it's concentration. This is concentration. This is concentration. This is concentration. Now concentration is equal to now moles per liter of solution. That's number of moles per unit volume of solution. Since volume is not given, therefore it's constant in all the cases. It is same in all the cases. Therefore, I will write this. Number of moles is 1/4. Number of moles is 1/4. Number of moles is 2/3. Number of moles is 2/3. Therefore, I can write it over here. I can write it like this. Kc will be equal to 1/4 into 1/4 divided by 2/3. Sorry, or 2/3 and 2/3 of. I'm sorry. Kc will be equal to product of concentration of product is. Product is ester, that is 2/3 moles of ester. 2/3 moles of water divided by concentration of these reactants, that's 1/4 moles of acid, 1/4 moles of alcohol. Now see, volume is same, therefore we have volume over here, number of moles per unit volume, volume will get cancelled in all the cases. Now solving this equation, we get 2 2s are 4, 3 3s are 9, 4/9 divided by 1 1s are 1, 4 4s are 16, that will be equal to 4/9 into 16/1, that will be equal to 64 divided by 9, that will be equal to, now say 7.4 something. This will be equal to equilibrium constant of the reaction. This will be equal to equilibrium constant of the reaction. this will be equal to equilibrium constant. 2 2s are 4, 3 3s are 9, 1 4 4s are 16. 4 by 9 into 16 by 1. That will be equal to like this. This is how you have to approve the problem. Let us take one more question. Write down the question. Let me see the length of the video. It's 20. The video is getting longer. I will ask you a question and you will determine it on your own. Now consider the same reaction CH3 COOH plus C2H5OH. It gives ester CH3COOC2H5. This is ester plus it gives water. Now the equilibrium constant for this reaction is 4. What will be the composition of the equilibrium mixture when 1 mole of when one mole of acid, this acid, acetic acid, is taken with 4 moles of ethyl alcohol, is mixed with 4 moles of ethanol, C2H5OH. Now we have here to determine what? We have to determine composition of equilibrium mixture. Now see what will we do. Solution of this question will come like this. CH3COOH. It combines with alcohol, C2H5OH. It gives ester, CH3COOC2H5, plus it gives water. Now see, we have to react 1 mole of this and 4 moles of this. And at time t is equal to 0, there is nothing happening in the reaction. This will be 0, this will be 0. Now after a certain time, product begins to be formed. Let at equilibrium, x moles of this decompose. If x moles of this decompose, what remains over here? 1 minus x. Time t is equal to t seconds. 1 minus x. How many of this will remain? 4 minus x. How many of this will be formed x and how much of this will be formed x? Now see, applying the law of mass action. If you apply law of mass action, Kc will be equal to concentration of product is, that's concentration of x into concentration of x, divided by concentration of reactant is, that's concentration of 1 minus x into 4 minus x. Now solving this equation, we get concentration of x square divided by 1 minus x into 4 minus x. This is 1 minus x into 4 minus x. You will solve it. 1 minus x into 4 minus x is equal to our Kc. This Kc is given, it is equal to 4. Therefore, it will be equal to 4. Solving this mathematical equation, you will get the value of x, that will be the composition of equilibrium mixture. This is how you have to solve the questions. Thank you for watching the text lecture. We will discuss QP and QC of reaction and then Richard Lear principle, then chemical equilibrium will end. We will start then ionic equilibrium. Thank you for watching.